The Fall of Mammoths. When a tragedy reaches its peak, the next step is the beginning of its catastrophic downfall. Well, well, well. Open your eyes. You may not believe or just imagine you have been blindfolded, including your predecessors. The first modern pharmaceutical medicine was invented in 1804 in the West. A huge effort was immersed to put an end to the Eastern ancient medicine, mostly from Egypt, China, India, Greece, and Rome. Such drive became more engaged as scientists became much more involved in doing intense laboratory-related research studies, using chemistry and biology. As scientists got involved more in finding means to find cures and to protect against diseases that cause pandemics, such as viruses, pathogens, microorganisms, and other foreign invaders, the dependency of biochemistry through invented chemicals was believed to cure and prevent diseases and bring pandemics to an end. After the discovery of antibiotics, the Western Hemisphere contemplated such inventions as wonder drugs. Enormous fundings were assigned to support scientific research related to the entire healthcare system. Larger percentages of countries' GDP, gross domestic products, was set for the advancement of research and development. In a study conducted by two researchers from University of British Columbia, Davies J and Davies D in 2010, highlighted that antibiotics have always been considered one of the wonder discoveries of the 20th century. This is true, but the real wonder is the rise of antibiotic resistance in hospitals, communities, and the environment concomitant with their use. The extraordinary genetic capacities of microbes have benefited from man's overuse of antibiotics to exploit every source of resistance genes and every means of horizontal gene transmission to develop multiple mechanisms of resistance for each and every antibiotic introduced into practice clinically, agriculturally, or otherwise. The lack of basic knowledge on these topics is one of the primary reasons that there has been so little significant achievement in the effective prevention and control of resistance development. Penicillin was discovered by Alexander Fleming in 1928, and in 1940, several years before the introduction of penicillin as a therapeutic, a bacteria penicillinase, an enzyme produced by certain bacteria that inactivates penicillin so that bacteria have increased resistance to the antibiotic, was identified by two members of the penicillin discovery team. Once the antibiotic was used widely, resistant strains capable of inactivating the drug became prevalent, and synthetic studies were undertaken to modify penicillin chemically to prevent clearance by penicillinases, also known as beta-lactamases. Regrettably, the use of these wonder drugs has been accompanied by the rapid appearance of resistant strains. In this greatly enchanting Letters to the Editors article published in Nature magazine by two researchers, Abraham Chain E, 1940, emphasized that Fleming A, Britt J, Exp. Path 10226, 1929, noted that the growth of B. coli and a number of other bacteria belonging to the colitophoid group, types of bacteria found in urine, was not inhibited by penicillin. This observation has been confirmed. Further work has been done to find the cause of the resistance of these organisms to the action of penicillin. Despite all these scientific studies with regards to the antibiotics resistance, almost a century passed and the world accelerated its exponential growth in all fields of technological advances, including inventions of advanced diagnostic equipment, conducting complex surgical procedures, and advanced diagnostics in detecting all dysfunctions in the human body, which greatly contributed to the series of industrial revolutions. On the other side, regardless of a series of assertions with regards to advancement in pharmacology, the struggles of humanity from chronic ailments continued to rise. Viruses kept severely mutating, resulting in global alarming associated with a series of pandemics, striking the world economy much harder than ever anticipated. Convincingly, humans' dependence on drugs to cure chronic diseases and protect against viruses began to dissipate. most severely when governments began enforcing vaccine mandates against the recent COVID-19 pandemic due to a series of mutations in the SARS-CoV-2, the virus that caused the COVID-19 pandemic. To many, this was treated as infringement to their privacies, as they started wondering what the next steps could be once governments take powers to enforce people against their will. Our profound supplication to the big pharmaceutical companies to take this prospect to start reconstituting their investment to the wellness industry in preference over holding their grips thoroughly solidified toward drug development. The world should learn from grave misconceptions that were committed by many of the collapsed industries. To name a few, Amazon has taken over many of the mega shopping complexes. Uber replaced taxi services. Online travel agents replaced most of the traditional travel agents. Online news replaced newspapers, etc. Our modest suggestion to the many sectors in the wellness industry, with the aim to withstand rapid growth, they should firmly adhere to partner with acclaimed scientific research institutes to keep themselves in conformity with the mega evolution of the entire world is yet to witness, shoulder to shoulder with the exponential growth of technological changes. The recent discovery of Haqua Revitalized Therapy, HART, in just a few years to come due to the freedom of information, vast provision of the social media globally, for the reason humans will finally uncover the truth behind the difference between a creature and an invention, in which all drugs are invented, regardless of enormous clinical research studies having been conducted. The fact is human wars against diseases and pandemics kept growing dramatically in the opposite direction of technological advances. Beyond the shadow of a doubt, humans' potentials were strictly limited towards invention and discovery. No creature, whether human, insect, animal, including all living organisms, could be invented nor engineered by humans. Rather, humans are obliged to acknowledge how every single nature function, including humans themselves. Whereas exclusively, humans through their advanced scientific skills should adhere to carefully study how every nature works and how each is made up of body which represent a system. Where on the other side is it made up of its essential natural supplements? We coined them fuels, and for the human body it strictly relies on preserving the required amount of each of its fuels. We coined them the four essential elements of life, feels, namely water, oxygen, hydrogen, and energy. The 21st century global evolution will absolutely encounter the hasty fall of the mammoth, as hospitals would be replaced by wellness resorts and spas, clinics by wellness centers, etc. Whereas accident and emergency units would survive to sustain lives, the rapid collapse would grow exponentially the moment a series of lawsuits would be filed on the global level, mostly from the developed countries against the world's biggest pharmaceutical companies.
All intellectual property rights reserved to Faris AlHajri, PhD, AM. Founder of Haqua Revitalized Therapy, HART. Haquapathic Medicine, HAM, or simply, Haquapathy, 2007 to 2021. Haqua Wellness, Blacksburg, Virginia, USA. https://haquawellness.com. https://farisalhajri.com.